And then the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam ascends to the seventh heaven. The gatekeeper of the seventh heaven, who will ask, who is it? Jibreel will say, it's Jibreel, do you have anyone with you? He says, yes, I've got Muhammad. Was he summoned? Yes, he was. Welcome. They opened the gate of the seventh heaven for the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam to be welcomed. There, in Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam will meet with his grandfather. His grandfather and his descent from Ibrahim alayhi salam. And while the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is relating his story and his experience of the ascension, every time he speaks about a prophet, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam describes him. He looks like this and he looks like that. And then in Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam, for him to get the image closer and say, he looks like one of these companions. And he looks like one of those companions. But when he came to Ibrahim, he said, there's no one that looks like him closer than me. I'm the closest person that looks like him. I met with my grandfather Ibrahim, and no one looks closer to his appearance as much as I do. And then Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and he had his back leaning to the Bayt al-Ma'mur. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of the Bayt al-Ma'mur in the Quran al-Kareem. And the Bayt al-Ma'mur is the sacred and holy house in the heavens. How we've got one on in earth, how we've got one on the surface of this earth, which is the Kaaba, there's one in the heaven called Bayt al-Ma'mur. And some of the scholars say Bayt al-Ma'mur is exactly parallel to Mecca and Kaaba. Ibrahim alayhi salam had his back leaning to Bayt al-Ma'mur. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he says, every single day Allah creates 70,000 new angels that will visit Al-Bayt al-Ma'mur and do tawaf, circulate around the Bayt al-Ma'mur and never come back to it ever again. Every single day 70,000 new angels are being created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam recites and he says, وَمَا يَعْلَمُ جُنُودَ رَبِّكَ إِلَّا هُوَ. No one knows the soldiers of Allah except Allah himself. Imagine, for the thousands, if not the millions of years that's gone past, every single day Allah creates 70,000 new angels. In another hadith, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he says, the heavens had shook and they have the right to shake. There's not even one handspan empty without an angel, without a malak, without an angel prostrating and bowing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, I saw my grandfather, that no one resembles him as much as I do. Ibrahim alayhi salam leaning his back to the Bayt al-Ma'mur. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam greets his grandfather Ibrahim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Ibrahim responds back and he says, wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullah. A righteous prophet and a righteous son. The other prophets beside Adam, a righteous brother. But Adam and Ibrahim, a righteous son. And they are proud of this son of theirs, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he says to him, O Muhammad, convey my salam to your nation. Say assalamu alaikum to my nation. So what should we respond back to Ibrahim? Wa alayka assalam ya Ibrahim. He's sending you salam. When someone comes up to you, he says, you know, I just met this brother, and he says to you, assalamu alaikum. You should respond back the salam. Wa alayka assalam ya Ibrahim. And then he says, oh Muhammad, tell your nation that the paradise is so beautiful. The paradise is so nice. It's so green. And it's a flat surface. And the structure and the plants and the trees of the paradise is your remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when you say subhanallah walhamdulillah wa la ilaha illallah wallahu akbar. So every time you say subhanallah, Allah azza wa jal will plant for you a tree in the paradise. Then the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he says, it will take a quick Arabian horse over 150 years for him just to cross the shadow of this tree. And then the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam ascends. He sallallahu alayhi wasallam ascends above the seventh heaven, where he reaches to Sidrat al-Muntaha, the final destination of the creation of Allah of this world.